Hi there, this is Vadim Michalenka, and in this quick video, we're going to look at how you can create floor plan diagram using Microsoft Visio. So stay here with me on this channel.
First, let's start by understanding what floor plan is. Floor plans are a scale drawing that show the relationship between rooms, spaces, and physical features viewed from above. Floor plans have many different purposes. For example, if you want to see how your future apartment or house will look like, you would want to look at the floor plan. And this is why it's heavily used in architecture. You can imagine how you can move from room to room and redesign your floor plan, if necessary, before building starts. It is a lot of fun to experiment with different alternatives in the floor plan to make sure you get to the right design. I had a very specific need to calculate square footage before purchasing hardwood floors. I wanted to know the exact number of hardwood floor packs that I need to purchase before the installation. To do this calculation, I decided to use Microsoft Visio, create floor plan, and then use automatic features of Visio to calculate square footage. And this is what we're going to focus on in this video. I'm going to show you how to create a simple floor plan, how to do calculations, and how to use all the cool features Visio provides related to floor plan. To create floor plan in Visio, you need to launch the application and type floor plan in the search box. As you can see, there are a lot of different plans Visio allows you to create, like office layout, home plan, floor plan, directional map 3D, and a lot of others. So if you need those specific ones, please explore those options. But in this video, we're going to focus on the floor plan. I'm going to click on the floor plan. And as you can see, Visio brings all the stencils on the left needed to create the floor plan. By default, Visio opens walls, shells, and structure stencils. But you also have points of interest, electrical and telecom, drawing tool shapes, and dimensional architecture. And you can also add more shapes as needed. It is very simple to create floor plan if your room is rectangular. You just select rectangular room in Visio and bring it in into the main screen. Visio allows you to zoom in so you can see bigger size of the room, and you can see the sizes. So make sure as you're creating floor plan that you measure the size of the room first, and then you can adjust the sizes here in the application. This particular room we are looking at is 21 feet by 26 feet and 3 inches. Now let's add a door into our room. You can just drag the door stencil and it will automatically adds into the wall. So this is the door. You can do a couple things with the doors. You can make it bigger depending upon what the size of your door is. Typically it's 3 feet door that you have in the room. So you can play with this. If it's hard to adjust it with just the mouse, you can always click properties and say, okay, my door is 3 feet. And it will become a 3 feet door. You can also change how far the door is opened here, and obviously doors can open and close in a different sizes of the room, so you can play with that too. To do that, you just do a right mouse click and you can say revert left right opening. You can do that, or you can also reverse in and out opening. So those are the very cool features. As with any Visio stencil, you can copy and paste. So if you select the door, you can copy the door and then paste it. And I accidentally selected Format Painter, which I didn't intend. So you can select the door, click copy, and then click paste, and it will create another door. if you want to maintain this size, so maybe it's the walkthrough room, right? This way you don't have to adjust the sizes after you create it. Creation of windows in the floor plan is also extremely easy. You drag the window stencil into the room and drop it right on the wall. You can adjust window sizes the same way. If your house consists of just rectangular rooms, you can bring in another rectangular room and adjust as needed. And you can do as many of those rectangular rooms as you need. As a next step, you can add doors and windows into those new rooms that you just put together. On the other hand, if your house does not have rectangular rooms, but all the rooms or some of the rooms are odd shapes, Visio still makes it possible to do floor plan even for odd shape rooms. To do floor plan for the odd shape rooms, you need to bring in wall stencils one after another and create configuration of the room of the odd shape. It is a little bit more work, but the good thing, it is still possible. The reason I selected Visio to create a floor plan is because Visio can calculate square footage of the created floor plan automatically. This is a very nice feature and very useful if you're trying to calculate square footage, especially for odd shapes room. To calculate square footage, you need to take the space stencil and bring it into the space. In this example, I brought it into the first room I've created in this floor plan. The next step is you do a right mouse click and click auto size. And as you can see, the space stencil expanded to fill in the size of the room. And it automatically calculated the size, which is 551 square foot. You can also rename the office here by clicking on properties and saying what's the actual name of the room. It could be master bedroom in this example. If you think that the Visio is the right application to do the work that you're trying to do and build the floor plan, make sure to check out other training links I provide in the description for this video to help you learn more about Visio. And good luck on your project.
Have you enjoyed this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you will not miss the next one, and tell your friends about it. You can find links and downloads in the description section of this video. There are a lot of helpful links and a lot of other helpful information you will benefit from.
Make sure to check out my other relevant videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We have a lot of great stuff planned in the pipeline, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And if you'd like to get notified about all the new stuff that are coming out, make sure to subscribe to my email list as well. All links are here on the screen. Make sure to click to stay in touch. Thanks again for watching.